10 minutes, please. The name of Allah and prayers be upon Prophet Muhammad, his family and companions. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My thanks also to the organizers of this forum, and especially His Eminence, Dr. Sheikh Abdullah bin Bayya. And before going to talk about my paper entitled The Mistake in Understanding the Two Concepts of Jihad and Takfir. And I'd like to remind you of something that we did as part of the government that was established in Tunisia before the recent elections, that is to conduct a study with a poll or a questionnaire in order to prepare the religious atmosphere in compliance with the new constitution in Tunisia. And I think that among the repercussions and the dangers and the reasons of these dangers that we are suffering from in Tunisia and other Arab and Islamic countries is the growing of this extremism and limited understanding of the Sharia provisions. And I really congratulate you for this trend in this forum through your own examination of the terms or the terminology of jihad and excommunication. Now, I'll stop at a very important question that was raised to a group of people in that opinion or that poll or the question in the dialect of Tunisia. What is your opinion of the Syrians who, or the Tunisians who went to Syria to fight? And the answer came as for a large proportion of them, 43%, did not find a place for jihad in our age. 35% justified it as a kind of defensive jihad against foreign colonizers, and 13% had the ability to respond to these calls of jihad under the title of removing injustice against Tunisians and Arabs in general. Okay, 13%. How much does it represent? It represents 1.5 million people who will have the ability to go for jihad without asking about the truth behind jihad. And 85% of the religious circles, especially men, 55%, the youth, 50% of them under 35 years old, mostly, I mean, 75% from urban centers, and 55% did not join universities. Why did I start with this survey? I wanted to focus on the concept of the terminology in Tunisia. After the revolution, things were opened, and after this space of freedom, there was a kind of a complete religious desertification, and now the borders were open for all those coming, including those who entered with a big capital of money and with a certain extreme fundamentalism, preparing or holding training courses with huge amounts of money injected into our own country in order to create a new ideology that Islam lies in having or growing a long beard and shortening your dress and memorizing some verses ordering to fight without putting them into their own natural context. Now let's go back to the text itself or to the term, but the implications may differ from one context to another. Sometimes they contradict with each other, especially if they were used by those people who have their own concepts and patterns, or from people from other backgrounds and cultures. The same thing applies to terms like terrorism, jihad, and takfir, because they are now controversial and debatable, and there is a kind of purposeful debate or non-purposeful debate, especially after the 9/11 accident or attack. 2001, thousands of people, you know, were killed. They were innocent people. And thus, jihad was put as a concept of killing and terrorism, causing an intellectual and media and political war still being launched by international lobbies whose purpose is to distort the image of Islam and to widen the gap between cultures and civilizations, putting them in destructive wars and devastating wars. And thus, jihad became a phobia, something unacceptable, including the majority of Muslims. Now, what is the reality of jihad? What is its relationship to fighting? And is it correct that limiting its meaning to killing, or does it have a wider meaning? Let me come to the term that is to exert your own best possible in order to defend and to fight in all the different walks of life and not on the battlefields. It is the best efforts to be made in order to realize a good objective, and it covers three fields, that is to stand against yourself and to stand against Satan and to stand against the apparent enemy. And the mention of the Quran appeared as a meaning of doing your best to spread Islam and to defend it, as it happened in the prophetic traditions, as the acts of the hearts and not to be done by your hands or your tongues, as per the saying of Prophet Muhammad, those who fought with him with his hand is a believer, and those who fought with their tongue are believers, and those who fight by their own heart are believers, such as defending your nations and your borders is a kind of jihad, and they'll be the first who enter paradise. The sunnah of Prophet Muhammad considered al-hajj, or the pilgrimage to Mecca, is one of the fields of jihad in Islam, where one forgets about the whole world and the ornaments of the world and the material things and how to coexist with other animals and with other creatures and plants and flora and Fiona, and thus this means that jihad is always the exertion of your efforts all over these fields and not only to fight. Furthermore, the meaning may mean the religious sacred fight or war. The followers, observers of this term will find it in many images and pictures. First, the fight against the self or the soul. This is the first type of jihad in Islam, and this is the basic jihad imposed on each Muslim, that is to discipline your own desires according to the approach and the disciplines of Allah. But those who let themselves loose without controlling their senses, they will go to vice, and the self jihad is to know the religion and to know how to act. And Allah said in the Quran, you prophet, fear God and never obey the infidels and the hypocrites. And God is knowledgeable and omnipresent, and the prophet is ordered to fight. To fight here means starting with a self control. Those who are defeated in front of their own desires and interests, presumptives, cannot face an enemy. And thus, the self-disciplining jihad is the source of all jihads. As Jabir said, that the Prophet Muhammad said when he returned from the last conquest of Tabuk, that we returned from the smaller jihad to the biggest jihad. And the second one is that of dawah, or call for Islam. Do not obey the infidels and fight them in the biggest fight. This means that God ordered his prophet to fight the infidels, those who do not believe in this Quran, and thus he considered the education of Islam and the interpretation of the Quran and the similarities and the other details of Islam and the Quran is a kind of jihad. Jahidhum bih, that is, use this Quran as a jihad. And then the construction jihad. How do we build this nation? It's the duty of the of this nation to spread education and to establish factories and to dig wells and to reform lands and to grow plants and to raise and advance their industries. And this is what's called constructive jihad, because the nation is always facing enemies, and therefore it should be strong to face its own enemy. Now, qital, or fighting jihad, the reader of the Quran will find many verses talking about jihad and find many verses talking about killing. It had separated between jihad and killing because there is an indefutable, an irrefutable difference. The paper will provide you with the answer. Now, getting jihad out of its Islamic meaning and keeping it within one meaning will lead to this embarrassment, and this requires a deeper understanding of this term and a realization of its historical context and linguistic significance and Sharia within its own intentions. The first fact that from which we have to deal or to start in dealing with these problems is to reconsider the interpretation of the Hadith and the Quran, and to see the product of our own thinking and the reaction with our own reality. And there are many, many examples in this field. I think that whether we accepted the idea of cancellation or the combination of the verses, the problem remains in the minds of many people, and therefore we have to go to a strong evidence that will remove this difference and conflict and the apparent contradiction. And this will also take the whole intentions of Islam. Peace is a general intention and an important part and partial of the moral and the ethical system of Muslims. Islam is derived from salam and peace and safety, and the Islam that we have known throughout our own history and civilization is that which calls for introduction, that is the interaction among nations, and this is one of the tenets of belief in the humanity and the human brotherhood, instead of denying it and the necessity that was imposed by sharing your own homeland with others. And this is a call for coexistence. Non-Muslims, if they do not start war and did not help to evacuate Muslims from their nations, we should coexist with them. And as per the Sharia, Islam refuses the philosophies that consider fighting as a kind of an instinct in our human race. And finally, we say that we should not confuse and mismatch between things that have their own Sharia foundations and those that violate the Sharia. And jihad and excommunication and other things are considered as Sharia principles and should be dealt with according to these principles, and they should show their as per their own fundamentals, and not to deny it, as some who have been hardly dealing with these things in the field of Sharia. Jihad as a general meaning, while fighting is a specific meaning, and fighting is a kind of jihad sometimes, but not every jihad is fighting, and we have to re-study and re-examine some terms, such as like that of war, appearance, fatḥ or conquest, and the dar of harb and Islam, and the house of Islam, house of war. Thank you very much.